Hey guys, so in today's video, I'm going to be talking about realistic art or realism in art industry. And the reason I wanted to talk about this topic in this video is because I've seen a lot of people just bashing artists who create realistic art for no real reason. So without any further ado, let's just jump right into the video. Also in the background, I'll be playing one of my own creations, one of my own realistic artworks that I created in the past traditionally, and I'll be putting that in a time-lapse format so that you guys have some visuals to look at. So those are my own realistic artworks I used to do traditionally. So yeah, a little background on me. I used to do a lot of realistic art traditionally, not digitally. So I've been doing that for a long time. What I've learned over the years is realistic art ain't easy, and I'm still learning how to create realism or realistic art digitally, because it's kind of really difficult as compared to traditional art in my eyes, at least. So it's quite easy for me to create a realistic artwork on paper, but when it comes to create it on a digital platform or software, it is kind of difficult for me personally. So I'm still learning it. I'm not perfect at it yet, but I've seen a lot of people just bashing realistic artists just because they are creating a exact same copy of their reference. And so they just start bashing the artist that this is not art, this is not real art, you're just copying the whole thing, and you're just exactly just copying the whole reference on the paper or maybe on any software. So the first thing that I want to mention is realistic art is not at all easy. Not everybody can do that, you know. It takes time. First of all, it is a time-taking process, because you kind of study the whole reference, and then you have to create an exact same one and give it a real 3D-ish look on a paper or maybe on some software, and that is not at all easy. So for people who come out and bash such artists, I just want to say to you guys, I know this might offend some people. If you are one of them, just know if something offends you, that means there is something inside of you that needs healing and you're still wounded from. So yeah, so I just wanted to say that it's just your jealousy that is speaking and not really you, because somewhere deep down you wish to create something realistic in your life, but you're still not there yet, and that is why you feel kind of insecure about it, and that is why you feel the need to, you know, put other artists down or other people down so that you can look good in your own eyes. And that's how it really works when we, you know, talk bad about somebody. So just don't take this personally, but I just feel that we should appreciate each and every artist. Each and every art takes time, takes efforts and skills. I'm not saying that realistic art is way better than any other art form or flat art or any other art form. I'm not saying that, because every art is unique, different and beautiful. What I am saying is, just because somebody else's style is really different and you're not there yet and it's not your style and that is not something that you do, there's no need to bring them down or, you know, talk bad about them just to feel good about yourself. That's what I feel. If you see my Instagram, I do not create realistic artwork anymore, and whatever I create, those are just fantasy artworks that I create, because I'm still learning how to do that digitally, because it's really difficult for me to do that only software. For some reason, I'm kind of practicing still. I'm not there yet. I'm not perfect. But at the same time, just because I'm not perfect at it yet, I don't go out and, you know, degrade other people who are doing it really, really well. I've seen a lot of artists on Instagram creating really, really beautiful realistic artworks, and I used to think, will I ever be able to create something like this or not? But then I later realized that that is not really my style, and I got into fantasy artwork and creating these glowing things around portraits and stuff like that, and I'm not really kind of interested in realistic artwork anymore, but I just wanted to say that realistic art is still an art form and it takes a lot of skills, efforts, time to create a realistic art piece. So just don't go out and bash on other people just because you cannot do that. Just realize that you are insecure about something, fix that rather than putting other people down. And I would really love to know what you guys think about it, and what do you guys think about realistic art in general, and if you have ever tried. And yeah, that's it for today's video. I just wanted to talk about it, just wanted to create a video out of this topic because I've just seen a lot of people doing this, and we should just start appreciating each and every art form no matter what. So yeah, just let me know what you guys think, and if you're gonna put any hate comment down in the comment section below, because I'm kind of expecting that, just know that still there's something in you that needs healing, and that just know that somewhere deep down you are kind of insecure, and that is why you feel the need to put hate on other people. And that's not a bad thing, just to realize that, because we all do that and we are not perfect. Not everybody is perfect, right? We all do that. And you just have to realize that it's not the external world that is triggering you. It's something inside you which needs a little bit of fixing. So yeah, I really hope you guys enjoyed this video. I never do such kind of video on my channel. I always post tutorials, so if you want to check out tutorials, go ahead and do that. I have a lot of tutorials on my channel at this point. Other than that, let me know what you guys think about the realistic art thing. And yeah, if you want to follow me on Instagram, I will link it down in the description. Other than that, I will see you guys in my next video.